Are you saying that, so in Israel, are they dumping in Palestine, or are you, is there a similar situation with waste in Israel?
Similar to the waste siege I was grabbing you? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's an interesting question, because,
race is generative. It's so important. And so what I want to ask was, do you envision within Palestinian communities, within the line of sight around the community among colleges and communities, where they're confronting an occupation that says, oh, you don't have the expertise to try and send it to the campus. Is this in turn motivate Palestinian, really Palestinian students to go abroad?
two spread waste of ethics. And I was just wondering where we could see those.
Oh.
I'm thinking about the bread, and I find that so interesting that people put it outside the dumpster. And I guess I'm wondering, is it simply that bread is sacred and you can't put it in the dumpster? Or is it that it's a kind of recycling movement that they would hope someone picks it up and uses it again? And then that makes me think, what other kinds of recycling impulses are there? Are there movements within Palestine to do something different with trash?
Yeah. Mm. Great question. I mean, goes to the landfill. No, no. So one of the interesting things, and this goes back to the application, is that Israel controls the borders, all of the borders, and it's absolutely And because of the occupation, as I was saying yesterday, in regards to health information, like the effects of police on health, it's very hard for anyone to have a God's eye view of what's happening. So Israel doesn't have the whole story of what's happening, and the Palestinian authority also doesn't have the whole story. So when they put you to the data, like statistics on how much they just produce and have effects on the reality, there's always like people who feel like, except for these other kinds of places for which there's no information. You know, and then like journalists will track a smuggler and produce an article like this is a little bit of fun. So it's really, there's a lot of gray. That's a level of
Hi, thank you so much for your talk. I learned a lot from it. I'm definitely a first-time caller, so my question would be all over the place, but I guess I have a two-point question for you. Well, in one sense, I was thinking in your presentation, I was reminded of Brett Walker's work on toxic archipelago in his environmental history of Japan. One of the things he lays out quite clearly is how the discourse of sacrifice and pain is so essential for making the nation manifest. And I was wondering, in the case of Palestine, is the peculiarity of your project, of your case, one where the state exists only in a phantom state, but the nation always eludes it, and the waste then becomes, in that sense, a metaphor for that sort of an illusionary idea of a nation. But also, a second part was, in many ways, your work also is almost the mirror image of, I want to say, Wiseman's Hollow Land. And as he shows how infrastructures of different kinds naturalize the place of Israeli occupation, I was wondering if your logic could allow for us to think that since you say, of course, that you know, it's not the matter out of place, could the waste then be producing all sorts of excess meanings, which is to say that maybe in a metaphorical and literal sense, the landfill spills over and becomes an alibi for Palestine to reclaim some of the lost land? I mean, of course, maybe I'm living in a fool's paradise, but I'm assuming that under occupation, maybe waste becomes what cellular technology was for Israel and Weizmann's Hollow Land, or all sorts of other things.
Yeah, thank you for those questions. to the beanie. All right, so are we going to talk later? Should I take the first?
When we were in Ramallah a few years ago, our taxi driver commented, I asked him, why are these big dumpsters on the medians in Ramallah? And he says that the Israelis tax those living in Ramallah for waste collection and disposal, but they do not furnish it.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know if that's
yes.
correct?
I think that what you're talking about is the big road that goes between Ramallah and Columbia checkpoint.